time around, you will do it. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Majority of us, we want to come back to God and remind God of all the things we've asked Him and then He never answered, and we have not forgiven God.
Hallelujah.
Maybe you even want to tell God in your prayers, God, I'm still angry with you. I'm saying maybe you come to God in your prayer and say, God, I'm still angry with you. Some people are capable of that. Because their heart is unforgiving. They don't like to forgive. But God is saying, be like a child in the kingdom of God. A child forgives. You too should be able to forgive. Make your request known unto God. Not holding God on the account of 1929. Hallelujah.
Amen.
How will God bless you? Amen.
Amen.
But be like a child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You lie to them, they still come back to you and ask you, the same person who lied. And then you lie, then they still come back, they forgive.
They forgive.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But we, some people say, over my dead body, I will not forgive that person. Why? Why? But God is saying, it shouldn't be so. Because in His kingdom, for you to partake or to enjoy the privileges of His kingdom, you must be forgiving. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Applause for Jesus Christ. We must forgive. We must forgive. We must let go. All the time. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Romans 8:28. If you are there, please, you can wait for us.
Twadiva asi avavahara karunga ininke na inye karunga kuiva gendesera momua avagahorora karunga mokuliza nostambo sendi.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is the reason why you need to trust God.
Esizo konta no ukubara karunga.
The Bible is saying this.
Bibere wakuyungasi.
All things work together for good. One, for those who love the Lord.
So karunga.
And we said kids are loving. Then it continues, says those who are called
Asorazigida
by God
karunga.
According to His will. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Now the reason why you need to trust God completely is because you did not call Him. You didn't invite Him. You didn't bring Him into existence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
But He called you. In other words, He invited you. He chose you. He desired that there should be someone like you. Then He brought you into existence. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So you don't know anything concerning Him. But He knows everything concerning you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That's why you should come back to him with complete trust. Because he is your creator. Because he knows everything. Because he has everything under control. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. When we find ourselves into situations, we like too much to complain. Why this one? But God is working behind the scenes. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Before he can finish to bring what he wants to bring, you have already complained. You have already changed strategies. And it hinders the process. And when it is not working again, you blame God. While God was busy doing something else. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You see, this reminds me of one time. My wife was cooking a meal in a different way that I do not know how it is done that time. Then me, I know it the way I know it. So I walked into the house. I told her I'm hungry. She said no, she was preparing something. Then she said I should check for her pots. I check, okay, everything looks fine, but except there's no salt. But I didn't know she deliberately chose not to put salt because she's preparing something special. I just put the way I know it should put. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because me, I just want my hunger to go. So why did you do it that way? I wanted to do it this way. Sorry. We can't eat it anymore the way we wanted it to be. Hallelujah. So many times we are like that. We come to God like that. We do not know what God is busy cooking. Because we have smelled the aroma. Then we say, okay, that must be spaghetti. In spaghetti there must be salt. In spaghetti there must be oil. Meanwhile, God is cooking something with cheese. It's spaghetti, yes, but he's putting cheese on top. And because we don't know, we take the salt and put in. We take the oil and put in. And the meal is spoiled. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And when we taste it, we'll be like, ah, it's not what we thought it should be like. But God is like, I told you you should wait. I told you I'm in the process. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Kids are trusting. They don't compete. They just make their request known unto God. After that, they are done. They wait upon you to fulfill your promises. Whether you are lying to them or you are not lying to them, it's not their concern. They only come back to you and say, where is my thing? That is the only thing they know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Applause for Jesus Christ. Jesus told them, for you to be the greatest in the kingdom of God, you must be like a child. Be like a child. Trusting. Loving. Forgiving. And humble. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let us finish with humble. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Or weak. 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 10. 2 Corinthians chapter 12 verse 10. It reads as follows. Oh, sorry, I'm on 1 Corinthians. Yes, it reads as follows. Verse 10 of 2 Corinthians chapter 12. Therefore, I take pleasure, or let me start from 7 rather. Unless I should be exalted above measure through the abundance of the revelations, there was given to me a thorn in the flesh, the messenger of Satan to buffer me, lest I should be exalted above measure. For this thing, I besought the Lord thrice that I might be depart, that it might depart from me. And he said unto me, my grace is sufficient for thee, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. Most gladly, therefore, will I rather glory in my infirmities, that the power of Christ may rest upon me. Therefore, I take pleasure in infirmities, in reproach, in necessities, in persecution, in distress, for Christ's sake. For when I am weak, then I am strong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
We said kids are weak.
Asiva nona kapiwa kara nongondo.
In the kingdom of God,
Montungi wa karunga,
or the reason why Jesus said you must be like kids, because one of the characters of kids, they are weak. And because we know they are weak, we do not lose our sight on them.
Hallelujah. Amen.
We are there to help them. Paul here is telling us that when he had an infirmity, when he was in pain, he looked or he sought God. And God told him and said to him that his grace is sufficient, that when he is weak, that is when God is made strong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God does not want to see our mightiness. When it comes to the spiritual things, it's not our strength. It's not
our,
but our complete trust in God, our complete faith in Him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Our own physical strength cannot be counted in the kingdom of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Let me ask you a question. If it depended on our physical strength, how many of us would access healing from God? How many of us would, go and pick healing from God and heal themselves? Because there are those of us slim like a mosquito. We can be blown away by wind. And because you are weak that time when you are sick, your power is very little. You cannot push around others to pick the healing that you want. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
But it's your total dependence on God. Is believing the word of God that works for you. It is the one that brings about the healing. Trusting God. Believing that by the stripe of Jesus Christ you are healed. When you believe it and exercise it, it works for you. That's how kids are. They trust you completely. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they'll tell you, pick this for me, put it there. When you ask them why, say, I can't. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
My daughter will tell you, tie my shoe. Then you tell why.
Say,
because I don't know, but you know. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So open for me the door. See, because I don't have power, you have power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
This is what God wants to hear from us. You tell him. Do it. Because you can, I cannot. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do it. Because you are able, I'm not able. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do it. Because you are God and I'm your child. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Do it. Because I'm weak. And you are strong. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
In the kingdom of God. For you to access the privileges of the kingdom of God. You need to be like a child. Not to act like a child. Not to behave like a child. Maybe you might leave this place. And you say, Pastor John read that scripture and said, Jesus said to them, be like a child. Now I'm going to behave like a child. That is not what the scripture is saying. He's saying, be like a child. Your way of reasoning. When it comes to faith, when it comes to believing God, you must be like a child. Complete trust, complete loving, forgiving, and be made weak in the sight of God. Hallelujah. Not to show your total control. To allow God to show the maximum control. Because He is God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
As we conclude, let us look into another scripture. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Isaiah 40, verse 29.
Yesaya egaono lolo noro ne verse zokuwa.
Isaiah 40 verse 29. If you are there, please read.
Verse zonoro mbali nantane. Age kunkondo peka avarupira nkondo avavaroroka.
Hallelujah. He
Amen.
Gives power to the faint, and to him who has no might, he increases strength. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Those that are weak, those without power, those are the ones that Jesus gives power. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The ones that are full of power is not after them. Because you already have power. What kind of power will He give you again? What kind of strength should He give you again? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when we come to God, we don't come to God as if we are stronger than God. Or we are equal mates with God. We come to God knowing He is God. We come to God knowing that He is almighty, that He is stronger, that He is the one to make us more stronger. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When you feel like things are getting worse, that is the time you turn to God. That is the time you tell God, Lord, I'm unable. Take charge. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
If there's any strength you need, is the strength to believe. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The strength to trust Him. The strength to believe upon His word. I don't think that takes physical strength. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes, to an extent, but not more than you need to lift, you know. That strength is not like the one you need to lift something. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Trust in the Lord.
Ukulareni makarunga.
Trust in the Lord.
Ukulareni makarunga.
Because that works in the kingdom of God.
Asi mairugana koso mtungi wakarunga.
If you want to partake to the privileges of the kingdom of God,
seno no harakuli hameka moba waga karunga,
is to be like a child.
Kareni kwe mnona.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Surely you will reap.
Pausiri tom fundu.
You will reap.
Asi tom fundu.
Shall we rise on our feet?
Tusikameni.
Hallelujah.